Уважаемые дамы и господа,
ladies and gentlemen,
уверен, что все I'm
convinced
присутствующие
that all those here understand the situation which is which has been developing worldwide and in Europe.
Предыдущие выступления подтверждают
the previous speakers have confirmed this.
Благодарю российских
I would like to thank my Russian colleagues for the opportunity to share my views of the problem issues of the global security.
2 года назад,
2 years ago,
мы констатировали, что в мире и Европе
We see signs of war in the world and Europe, and we can see that war is already at the door. But this is not the classical war where countries have military conflicts. No, in our opinion, we see a global proxy war for the future model of global formation between transnational and national elites. The beneficiaries of this war try their best to stay unseen, but we can see them. We see that the protectors of the unipolar world claim for their global ambitions. Their purpose is to destroy independent governments and to eradicate borders between countries and nations. They do their best to implement the controlled chaos strategy to this end. Well, this is where they use the so-called concepts of color revolutions and hybrid wars. The global pandemic of coronavirus has been promoting the controlled chaos too. The lockdowns against COVID have reached their aims. A serious blow has been dealt on national economies worldwide. People have stopped to trust the governments. They are in fear for their future. Let us look at what has been happening worldwide. People have been coming to the streets on the top land. Anti-government rallies have been taking place throughout the planet, starting from Europe and the US and all the way to South America, Africa, and islands in the Pacific. We see a wave of color revolutions that has overwhelmed the post-Soviet states. In other words, we see conditions where this case can destroy the governments and states and their belts can be robbed. The Republic of Belarus has been no exception from this list. The people of Belarus was also engaged in this global chaos. Without understanding the real purposes or intentions of this global chaos, a part of the Belarus society was protecting the open Belarus, but they did not understand that the Wall Street bosses offer them a model where there's no place for independent states. But we don't have any mask anymore. We see that there's another attempt to rebuild the world. We see that the Republic of Belarus, just like any country, is just a pawn in this big chess game for the great reset. We're just a field where fight is being held for the wealth of Russia. And we will not have to stay aside out of this fight. It is highly likely that in the post-coronavirus pandemic, this fight will undergo more acute. Breaking independent states will continue in all the possible ways. A whole set of efforts have been undertaken already in this respect. Firstly, we see that the international institutions of security have been discredited. They've been criticized for their passive positions and their unwillingness to solve international problems, and this is quite justified. They have been trying to do their best to keep their budgets. The UN, the OSCE have become victims to donor states, and they have taken to account their highly politicized agendas. In this, no support to small countries can be provided, and these countries cannot keep their independence. Two, the architecture of international treaties has been destroyed in the area of international security and control over arms proliferation. Such important treaties as this, the Treaty on the Conventional Arms in Europe, the Treaty on medium and short-term missiles, the chemical convention, the open skies have simply stopped to agree, or they're being openly ignored with tacit agreement of international organizations. We see only the exception of the START 3 treaty, because it is directly related to the threat of nuclear destruction of the entire planet. In the context of no treaties, individual countries and private companies have started to do open research in the area of creating new weapons of mass destruction. We see new research in the area of biological engineering. Aspects. 2 years ago, in the Beijing Forum, we pointed out that there's a threat that comes from the biology labs in the post-Soviet countries. Representatives of the Pentagon rule these labs now, but people wouldn't hear us. We hope that the COVID pandemic, whose source cannot, nobody can sell, not even WHO, this will make the international community to understand how important it is that the WMD threat is growing. Three, no system of checks and balances has resulted in the fact that the powers that be feel that they can do anything, and they don't stop at crossing the conventional red lines. This is what we may call governance-sponsored terrorism. The first hamburger of this change was the murder of the Iranian General Qasem Soleimani. Just a couple of months ago, the Republic of Belarus has also seen this. We saw this phenomenon as well. During the joint operation of Belarusian and Russian security services, we stopped the preparation of a revolt with the physical killing of the head of the Belarusian state and members of his family. Today, during the investigation, we have gained an irrefutable evidence of the fact that the U.S. government authorities have been involved in this. Four, we're being taught that the war is inevitable. The mass media have been publishing more and more often forecasts on the escalation of this situation and the results of possible actions of global powers and various theaters of military operations. People have been getting accustomed to the fact that military conflicts are a regular way of world affairs, the so-called normalcy. At the same time, we see that new strategic settings are being developed, the forms and methods of new approaches to war. We see an example, for instance, that the Pentagon has developed a concept for global integrated multi-domain operations. And documents are already being prepared to develop this, and programs for developing of military forces have been prepared. At the same time, we see more attempts to transform the U.S. occupation regime in Europe. This is how we believe should we call the deployment of U.S. Military forces in Germany and Italy after World War II, because they still are in Europe after the Yalta Conference in 1945, where the area countries of the former Hitler coalition were divided into occupation areas. We developed the concept of Europe of various states, the concept of Anglo-America and other vectors of European policy. And as we used to forecast, individual countries of Eastern Europe have had years when it became allies of the U.S. military powers. Poland, the Baltic states, and others have been trying to sell their independence again and offering Russophobia. Yes. Military forces have been entering Eastern Europe. A new military base is being built in Poland. A tank battalion has been deployed in the Baltic states and have been rotating just dozens of kilometers away from the borders of the Republic of Belarus. Ukraine has been inviting British troops to enter their territory. And we see that the military troops of third parties have been studying the theater of military operations close to our borders. Military budgets have been growing. We see that attack equipment is being bought at an enlarged scale. Five, the logic of occupation of European states by the U.S. makes it quite clear why they react like this to the sovereign actions of the Republic of Belarus. Maybe they're concerned by the fact that European countries that in the conditions of actual occupation don't have this right to sovereignty. This is why the wish to make small Belarus a rogue state and to destroy it at the end. They've been not stopping to use hybrid war tools, trying to address the economy and anything which brings money. They fight for financial flows, economic sanctions, protectionist measures, unfair competition. They stop at nothing. For instance, the recent case with the Ryanair airplane, it has been used to reduce the transit potential of the Republic of Belarus, to kill the Belarusian air freight company and to destroy our navigation system. Six, the expansion will be carried out not only in the conventional areas. Our planet Earth to globalists and the transnational corporations is already too little. They have started to work and to fight even in the aerospace area. And we can forecast that the U.S. concept of privatizing the space will result into negative consequences. They have started to colonize neighbors' worlds and spaces in order to reserve the resources. And we should look from this perspective at the fact that they have announced that the airspace will be an area of military operations. That have been generating attack equipment, and state borders don't play any role anymore, because the arms will be just above our heads, just 100 kilometers away from their targets. We should also point out that transnational corporations and the governments that they controlled don't stop at the space. We can see already very clearly that they aim to dominate in the virtual cyberspace. The cyberspace is being militarized quite actively and becomes also another theory of military conflicts. Information technologies have become a new modern arms, weapon. Social networks, social services have become an active tool of promoting color revolutions and destroying states and governments. So there's a reason that countries that understand this see, look for ways to control over Facebook, Twitter, Telegram, and other messengers and social networks, because these become too dependent on these social networks. All the above trends demonstrate that transnational elites have been trying to solve their tasks using the governments that they control, among other things, and their institutions as well. At the same time, we see an intensive growth of another tool, private military companies. They've been discussed a lot in the previous forum, so I'll not repeat myself. Dear colleagues, these are just one of the most urgent aspects of the global security. They demonstrate that there's an unprecedented level of confrontation in the present world. The fight for the future model of global structure is underway. We see that governments have been trying to keep their sovereignty and individual character. This is why independent countries have been continuing to unite in clusters and blocks based on their joint civilization interests. The Republic of Belarus is the center of the European continent, actually at the borderline of conflicts between geopolitical conflicts between the East and the West, the North and the South. So we cannot ignore the process that are underway in the world. The Belarusian people have made their choice in the referendum in 2005, and we will continue, we'll accelerate our integration with the Allies as part of the Allied state, as part of the Treaty on Collective Security and Eurasian Economic Council.
And единую военную политику. В ее рамках мы предполагаем пересмотреть в союзных военных доктринальных документах понятие «противник» и «источник угрозы». Ведь крайне важно в условиях идущей прокси-войны противодействовать не только марионеткам, но и их кукловодам. Беларусь продолжит активно содействовать дальнейшему укреплению позиции ДКБ на международной арене. В вопросах обеспечения региональной безопасности мы продолжим развитие современной белорусско-российской региональной группировки войск. В ближайшее время с нашими российскими коллегами рассчитываем завершить создание совместных центров подготовки войск и сил как на территории Республики Беларусь, так и Российской Федерации в Калининградской и Нижегородских областях. В очередной раз планируем продемонстрировать высокий уровень оперативной совместимости, слаженности и полевой выучки войск в ходе предстоящего стратегического учения
Запад-2021.
И это не бряцание оружием.
Measures of operational preparations NATO our borders. Overall, we see that in this multilateral world, we need to develop a new rules for coexistence. We need to understand the negative consequences that can be brought about by raising the stakes of military confrontation. Over the past year, we have been able to demonstrate that Belarus will not give up. The time has come to stop and to sit down at the table of negotiations. And we keep a staunch position in this respect. We are ready to contribute to preventing any conflicts. The Minsk forum is open for such cooperation. Thank you very much.